Borderland Treasure, sponsored by Preservation Texas and the County of El Paso. We are taking you to the mission at Socorro, which tells the story of the Piro people through its architecture and art. Take a look. Envision a bird spreading its wings, taking flight, soaring upward into the sky above. That's the legend behind the design of the old Socorro Mission, or properly named Nuestra Señora de la Limpia Concepción de los Piros de Socorro del Sur.
The community was established on October the 13th, 1680.
That was the time of the Great Pueblo Revolt in northern New Mexico, where Indian tribes devised a plan.
There were simultaneous uprisings in the pueblos
to overthrow the Spaniards and expel them from their lands. The Piros.
There were many Piro pueblos. They've unearthed something like 14 of them.
Came from Socorro, New Mexico, south to the Rio Grande in the aftermath of the rebellion because they had sided with the Spaniards.
That group of surviving Spaniards fled
and placed themselves under their protection.
Brought a group from the southernmost tribe, the Tiwa from Isleta and the Piro from Socorro. Y aquí estamos.
The mission at Socorro del Sur, located just south of the river, was established 341 years ago. First with a makeshift church, then a permanent church that was completed by 1691.
This particular church is affected by natural disasters.
The church was destroyed in 1740 by a raging flood, rebuilt soon after at the same site, which today is marked by a large cedar. The church was destroyed again by another great flood in 1829, rebuilt once more further to the north. The present church has been standing for 178 years, the only surviving building in El Paso County dating to the Mexican period. The structure is made of adobe bricks, fashioned from mud, sand, and straw.
The walls are 4 to 5 feet thick.
You may notice there are few windows in the walls.
There was still a need to protect the inhabitants, and so you had architecture that was designed to protect people in case they were attacked.
And the interior of the nave, breathtaking, especially if you look up at its wooden vigas or beams.
We start with the vigas because those are the oldest, considered to be some of the oldest relics in the state.
Recycled from the first and second churches, the oldest dating to the 1690s, and their symbolism in their decoration.
We have people sometimes look up and they see X's. They're diamond shapes. The diamond shape in the viga represents the four points, north, south, east, and west.
The circle, Magda says, represents the sun. Sticks called latillas are laid diagonally atop the vigas. Magda said the alternating colors evoke the beating of a drum.
There's like a metaphor. Above us, we have a native. We have dancing and chanting and drumming. We have a native ritual going on above us.
Next to the church are two 19th century cemeteries and a rectory that once housed the priests and travelers from afar. The mission is listed on the National Register of Historic Places and is a Texas landmark.
We have people from all over the world and all over the country.
Many come to take a look at history for themselves as the beating heart of the Piro lives on in this treasure found in Socorro.
You can catch more Borderland Treasure segments on KTSM.com.